Hello students, myself Nisha Pandya, lecturer Mechanical Engineering, Government Polytechnic, Ahmedabad. So in last session we have discussed about projection of line when line is inclined to one plane and parallel to other plane. So how you will draw the projection that we have discussed in the last session. Now when the line is parallel to any plane, on that plane you will be having the true length. Because what will be the projection of a line? It can be a line or it can be a point. When the line is perpendicular, you will be having point in the projection. When the line is parallel to any plane, you will be having the straight line only. Now, we have discussed the cases when the line is inclined to one plane and parallel to other plane. Now, at last, we have discussed some thing about when the line is inclined to both the planes. Now, when the line is inclined to both the planes, how you will be getting the true length? Because no plane is parallel to the line. So, you will not be having straightway the true length in the projection. So, how you will get the projection of a line when the line is inclined to both the planes? So today we are continuing that session, that the case when the line is inclined to both the planes. Now what we have discussed is, first of all, what we have to assume is the line is inclined to one plane and parallel to other plane. Means suppose we are having the line, see over here, we have to assume that the line is first of all inclined to HP and parallel to VP. Line is inclined to HP and parallel to VP. Now in that case, what will be happen? That in the front view, you will be having the inclined line and of a true length, because the line is parallel to VP. And when you see from the top, you will be having a straight line. You will be having a straight line, but of a shorter length. Now this line, we are rotating in a way that it will be inclined to VP also. Then what will happen? That suppose this is your line AB. This is the line AB. This is the point A and this is the point B. So what we have to do is fix the point A. Don't move the point A. It will be fixed. And rotate the line so that it will be inclined to VP. Now we are not knowing the angle. Means we can rotate it completely circular, means 360 degree we are rotating. The inclination we are not knowing. So the theory is we are rotating the point B in a way that the total circle, the total 360 degree we are rotating, and our position of point A is fixed. Now when we are rotating this point B, so you can be having a circle. When you see from the top, the point B is the rotating in a circular path, and the same circular path, when you see from the front view, it will be having a line. Now see, when you are having the circular shape, suppose this is the circular shape, okay. Now this circular shape, when we are rotating point B, it will be having circle in the top view. Means this is the top view, it will be having a circle. But this circle, when you see from the front, can you see? This is the circle, but when you see from the front, you will be seeing only the line. You can see only line. So what will happen is, when you are having the line inclined to HP and then you try to rotate the point B, it will be having a circular path in the which view? In the top view. And that same view, you will be having the position of your point B. If you are seeing from the front view, it will be a line. Clear? And the second case is, now you make this line inclined to vertical plane. Now you have to put it in this way. Now if I will put the line in this way, my line is inclined to vertical plane and parallel to horizontal plane. Now this is the position, the line is inclined to vertical plane and parallel to horizontal plane. So in which view you will be getting the true length? In the top view, because the line is parallel to horizontal plane and you will be having the top view in the horizontal plane. So first of all, you can draw this top view, and when you see the front view, it will be a line only but of a shorter length. Clear? Now what we have to do is, now we have to make it inclined with which plane? Horizontal plane. Now we have to try to make it inclined with horizontal plane. So see, the same case here, my point A will be fixed. This is the point B and this is the point A. So my point A will be fixed and I will rotate the point B in a way that it will be inclined to HP also. Now I have to complete the whole rotation. So that it can be any angle. We are not knowing the angle. So what we are doing is, we are rotating the point B, the whole 360 degree, so that it can be inclined to HP also. Now you see, when we are rotating this, you can see in the front view. In the front view, you will be having which motion, which path you will be having, that is circular path. And in the top view, see, if you are having circular path in the front view, when you see from the top, it will be a line. Clear? When you see this circular shape, it will be circle in the front view, but if you see from the top, it will be having only line when you are seeing from this side. Clear? So this theory we are displaying on this. Now I will display on the slide that how we, you have to draw. Clear? So see, this is the first figure on which what we have discussed is, first of all, you have to make it inclined with HP. So first of all, you have to locate the position of your point A, that is above XY distance and below XY distance. Now the angle with HP is theta. So that A dash, and now why we have written this B1 dash? Because this is not the final front view. Okay, so this is the true length. So always you have to mark as B1 dash. So A dash, B1 dash, the angle is theta and this is known as true length. Now this is A dash, B1 dash, the true length. Now the plan of this line is the B dash or B1 dash or B1 should be in a one line. Now we have discussed the case when the line is inclined to one plane and parallel to other plane. So this is the case. We are drawing A dash, B1 dash at an angle theta. We are having the point A. So how you will locate B1? Because the length of AB1 is shorter than A dash, B1 dash. Clear? So from A, you have to draw the line parallel to XY. And from B1 dash, you have to draw the line perpendicular to XY. You can be at the intersection, you will be having point B1 first. Clear? So now what we have to do is, try to rotate the point B1 dash. Try to rotate the point B. So I have demonstrated it, that what you will be having in the top view, you will be having a circular path, and the same circular path you will be having as a line. So what you have to do is, from B1 dash, draw one line parallel to XY line and mark it as locus of point B in front view, or you can say locus of B dash. Clear? And same way, from point A, take A as a center and AB1 as a radius, draw one circle, and on that circle you can noting, you are noting that this is the locus of point B in top view, or you can say this is the locus of point B. So this is the first case. Now in second case, what we have done is, we are assuming that point or line AB is inclined to VP first. Okay, line is inclined to VP first. So what we can draw is, draw the line at an inclination with VP, that is phi. Draw the line of a true length, we have to mark as B2. Clear? Now, the position of A dash and A will be same. We are not changing the position of point A, we are changing the position of point B only. Clear? So, what we have to do is, now we have marked AB2. Clear? So, the front view of this line will be having shorter length. Clear? So, for this front view, what we are doing is, from A dash, draw one line that is parallel to XY, and from B2 draw the line perpendicular to XY. Both will intersect at some point, that is the point B2 dash. Clear? And now what we are doing is, we are rotating the point B so that it can be inclined to HP also. And in that case, you will be having circular path of point B in front view and line in the top view. So what we have to do is, from B2, draw the line parallel to XY and mark it as locus of point B in top view, or you can say locus of point B. Same way, take A dash as center, A dash B2 dash as radius, draw the circle and mark it as locus of point B in front view, or you can say locus of point B dash. Clear? Now, these two cases are different, but what we have to do is, we have to combine these both the cases. We have to combine these both cases. So what will happen when you combine these two? Here you are having locus of point B in front view as a line. Here you are having locus of point B in front view as a circle. So when you combine these two, your this circular motion or this path will intersect this line at some point, and that will be your point B dash. Same way here, in this case, you are having circular path of your locus of point B, and here you are having the line as a locus of point B. So when you combine these both figures, you will be having some intersection point of this circle and this line, and that will be your point B. Now, it will be clear from this figure. See, now here we have combined these two cases. So what you have to do is, from A dash, first of all, at an angle theta, draw the line of true length, that is B1 dash. From this, you will be having the top view, that is AB1, and draw the circle. Same way, the second case is, draw the line AB2 at an angle phi. From B2, take A dash B2 dash as a front view. From A dash B2 dash, draw the circle as a locus line or locus path. From B1 dash, draw the line that is locus of point B in front view. And same way, from point B2, draw the line parallel to XY, that will be the locus of point B. So now, see what will happen, that this circular path will intersect at point B, and this circular path will intersect your line at this point, that is your point B dash. So this is the final front view point, and this is final top view point. So this will you have to note as B dash, and this you have to denote as point B. Join A dash B dash, join A B. Now always, when you are drawing the projection of lines, your final front view and final top view line, you have to make it thick. Clear? So this is your final front view, this is your final top view, this is the angle you have to note as alpha, and this angle you have to note as angle beta. Clear? So I will demonstrate on teletop also that how you have to draw. See the case. First of all, what we have to draw is, first of all, draw the XY line. In the first case, what we are doing is, locate the point A dash, locate the point A at an angle theta, at an angle theta, and this is the true length, mark the point, this is B1 dash. Clear? Now from B1 dash, when you draw the top view of this line, it will be from B1 dash you have to draw the line perpendicular to XY. From A you have to draw the line parallel to XY, that intersection, that is B1 dash. Clear? This point you have to draw the line, that is locus of B dash. And from A, what you have to do is you are drawing the circle. Clear? You are drawing the circle, and that is locus of B. The second case is, what you are doing is locate the point A dash and A. Now make it inclined with VP. That point will be B2, and that line is locus of B. Same way, the front view of this line, here you can mark in this way, that is, here is B2. So this is your B2 dash. Clear? And the locus you are having circle over here, that is locus of B dash. Clear? So this is locus of B dash, this is locus of B, this is locus of B dash, this is locus of B. So what you have to do is you have to combine both these figures. So what you will be having is, first of all, draw the line XY, mark point A dash and point A at an angle of theta, at an angle theta, locate the point B1 dash and draw the locus line, that is locus of B dash. Now same way, you are having, here you have to locate your point B1. Now what we have to do is, at an angle phi, second case, at an angle phi, now this is also true length and this is also true length. At an angle phi, locate the point name is, you have to mark as B2, and this will be locus of B. Clear? Now from B2, draw the front view of AB2, that is A dash B2 dash. Up to this, it is clear? This is the first case and this is the second case. Now instead of circle, what we will do is we will only make the arc, we will only draw the arc. So from A dash as a center and radius equal to A dash B2 dash, draw the arc. So from A dash as a center, A dash B2 dash as radius, draw the arc up to the locus line, and that point will be your B dash. Clear? And same way, from A, take A as a center, AB1 as a radius, draw the arc in this way. Clear? So it will intersect this locus line at some point, and you have to mark it as point B. And now join A dash and B dash, join A and B. So this is the front view and this is the top view. Clear? Now you can cross check your this projection, that your B dash and B, your B dash and B should be on a same line. If you are getting your B dash and B on a same line, your projection is correct. Clear? So this is the figure you have to remember when you have to study about the projection, or when you have to draw the projection of line when the line inclined to both the planes. Now see over here in the slide, This is the pictorial presentation when line inclined to both horizontal plane and vertical plane. Clear? So this is the position of the line. This line is inclined to HP also, it is inclined to VP also. For the front view, the front view will be also the inclined line, and the top view also will be inclined line, but it is not of a true length, and so that's why you have to mark this angle as angle alpha and this angle as angle beta. The notations already we have discussed in that session, that the front view angle you have to denote as angle alpha and the top view angle you have to denote as angle beta. Clear? So that notations you have to follow when you are drawing the projections. Clear? So this is your A dash B dash and this is your AB. So here front view and top view both will not having the true length. Clear? So that's why you have to denote as angle alpha and angle beta. Clear? So the procedure in this animation also you can see, which we have drawn over here on teletop. What you have to do is, from A dash, again I am repeating, at an angle theta, draw the line of true length, that is B1 dash, and from A at an angle phi, true length, point is B2. Clear? From here, this is locus of B dash. This is from B2, you draw the line parallel to XY, that will be locus of point B. From B2, you can be having its front view. Clear? And make this arc. It will intersect this locus line, and that will be your point B dash. Join A dash B dash. So that will be your front view. And B dash and B should be on a same line. So either you can directly get the point B if you draw the line perpendicular to XY from the B dash, and it will intersect the locus line at some point. Clear? So in this way also you can have the point B, or the another we have drawn is A dash B1 dash. From A dash B1 dash, get the line or get this top view point, and from that point make the arc. It will intersect this locus line at point B. This is your final top view point. Join AB. Clear? So this is your final top view. This is your final front view. This is angle theta. The true length which will make the angle with horizontal plane, you have to mark it as theta. The angle with VP of true length, you have to mark it as angle phi. The front view angle, you have to denote as angle alpha. The top view angle, you have to denote as angle beta. Clear? So in this way, you can have this. So this diagram, you have to memorize when you are trying to solve the problems on the case when the line inclined to both the planes. Clear? And the same notations you have to use. Remember these notations. The location of your point A. Because what we have written is AB because the line is AB. Suppose your line is MN. MN line is given. Then you have to mark as M dash N dash. Clear? The line is PQ. Then you have to mark as P dash Q dash. If it is XY, then X dash Y dash. Clear? So, first of all, you have to try to locate the first point, because the position of your that point will be fixed. And if you are having the true length, clear? So the true length line and the angle of the true length line with HP, you have to mark it as theta. Same way, the angle of the true length line with the VP, you have to make it as, denote as phi. Same way, the true length and front view, so it will be A dash and B1 dash. And this line you have to mark it as locus of B dash. Same way, this line you have to mark it as locus of B. Clear? So, now we will solve this problem that the data is given that line AB is 75 mm long and it is 30 degree and 40 degree inclined to HP and VP respectively. Now, and A is 12 mm above HP and 10 mm in front of VP. Draw the projections. Now, the name of the line is line AB. So, before you try to solve the problem, what you have to do is, first of all, write down the data given. Now, which data are given? The true length is given, 75 mm. Then, the angles are given, 30 degree with HP and 40 degree with VP. So, angle theta and phi are given. And the position of your point A is given, 12 mm above HP, 10 mm in front of VP. Clear? So, see, I will demonstrate on the teletop. The data, first of all, you have to write down that true length is 75 mm is given. Clear? Then the angles are given. Theta is 30 degree and angle phi is 40 degree. Another is the position of your point is given, that is A dash, because 12 mm above HP, so 12 mm above XY. And where is the position of your point A? It is 10 mm in front of VP, so that distance will go below XY. Clear? A dash is 12 mm above XY, A is 10 mm below XY. So what we have to do is draw the line XY first. Draw the line XY. Clear? Locate the point A dash and A. A dash is 12 mm above XY. A dash. And this is your point A. This distance is 12 mm and this distance is 10 mm. Now, you are having the angle theta and you are having the true length. So what we can do is from A dash, take an angle of 30 degree. Take an angle of 30 degree. This angle is 30 degree. Locate the point, because this is the true length, 75 mm. Locate the point which will be which point, that is B1 dash. Mark as B1 dash. And from B1 dash, draw the line parallel to XY and mark it as locus of B dash. Now, next step is, this is the front view length, front of this true length. So, the top view of this line is, you have to make it as this way. From this perpendicular to XY, from A parallel to XY, both will intersect at some point, that will be your point B1. Now another is, which inclination is given? Inclination phi, that is at an angle of 40 degree. So what we have to do is, from A get the inclination of 40 degree, take an angle of 40 degree. And look, this length is 75 mm, this is also 75 mm. Locate point, you have to denote that point as point B2. You have to denote as point B2. Clear? And draw the line parallel to XY, passing from B2, and mark it as locus of B. Clear? And from B2, its front view will be, you have to draw the line perpendicular to XY and that will be your point B2 dash. Clear? Now what we have to do is, you have to get the arc. you have to get the arc. So what you will do is, from A dash, take A dash as center and A dash B2 dash as radius, get the arc, and which will intersect this locus line at some point. Clear? And that will be your point B dash. Same way, from point A, take A as a center, radius equal to AB1, radius equal to AB1, get the arc which will intersect your locus line at some point, and that will be your point B. Clear? Join A dash B dash, and here join AB. So this is the front view and this is the top view. Clear? So these are the steps how you will completely draw the projection of point. So now you can measure the length A dash B dash, you can measure the length AB, you can measure this angle alpha, you can measure this angle alpha, you can measure this angle beta, you can measure A dash B dash, and you can measure AB, and that will be your answer. Clear? So see in the slide, what we have to do is draw the XY line first. What we are doing is draw the line XY. Then first of all, locate the point A dash and locate the point A. Clear? Now the angles are given, the theta angle 30 degree and of true length, locate the point B1 dash. Same way, at an angle phi and true length, locate the point B2. Clear? Now look, draw the locus line. So from B1 dash, draw the line parallel to XY, that will be your locus of B dash. And same way, from B2, draw the line parallel to XY, that will be your locus of B. Now from B2, get its front view. Clear? Same way, from after getting this point, what we are doing is take A dash as center and radius equal to this much, that is B2 dash. You can draw the arc which will intersect this locus line at point B dash. Same way, what you can do is you can either directly get your point B, or what you can do is, what we have done on this teletop, that from B1 dash you will be having its top view, and from A and B1 you can be having the top view point, that is your point B. So this will be your front view and this will be your top view. Clear? Now another example we are taking, that the data is given, line AB 75 mm long makes 45 degree inclination with VP, while its front view makes 55 degree. Its front view makes 55 degree. Now, and A is 10 mm above HP and 15 mm in front of VP. If line is in first quadrant, draw its projections and find its inclination with HP. So here the data is given, that the line, the true length is given, the true length is 75 mm. Now 45 degree inclination with VP is given, 45 degree inclination with VP is given, and front view makes 55 degree. Front view makes 55 degree. That angle is alpha. Alpha angle is given. Clear? And the position of your point is given. The point is 10 mm above HP and 15 mm in front of VP. So how you can draw the projection when this data is given? So what you have to do is, first of all, you can have the data. The true length is given. true length is 75 mm. Now the angle with VP is given. The angle with VP is 45 degree. The angle is VP is 45 degree. And front view makes 55 degree. Front view makes 55 degree. Front view, so angle alpha is given 55 degree. And the position of point A, 10 mm above HP, 15 mm in front of VP. So A dash is 10 mm above XY and A is 15 mm below XY. A is 15 mm below XY. So now here the angle with HP is not given. The angle with HP is not given. But the data which is given, we can try to solve this problem. So first of all, what we have to do is draw the line XY. The position of the point A is given. So you can locate the point A dash and A, 10 mm above and 15 mm below. Locate the point A dash and A. Now the true length is given and angle phi is given, angle with VP is given. What we can do is from point A at an angle of 45 degree, and this distance is 75 mm. Locate the point that is your point B2. Now from B2 you can draw the locus line. This is locus of B. Now this is your AB2. So its front view will be, draw the line perpendicular to XY from B2, and from A dash you draw the line parallel to XY. You can be having B2 dash. Now here the length of front view is not given, only the angle is given. So what we can do is from A dash at an angle of 55, draw one line. Okay, we are not knowing the point B dash, but this angle alpha we are having, this is 55 degree. Now what you can do is remember our that figure. Always you remember that figure, A dash A, angle theta, B1 dash, and this will be your B1. Same way this is the phi, this is your B2, this is B2 dash. What we are doing is getting the arc. And here what we are doing, getting the arc from this. So this will be B dash and this will be B. Now see, in our case, we are having this A dash and not having this point B dash, but this line we are having. Now this line will intersect at which arc? The arc passing from point B2 dash. Clear? So now we are having the point B2 dash and we are having this line. So what we can do is from A dash as B2 dash, get the arc. It will intersect your line at some point and that will be your point B dash. So what we can do is take A dash as center, A dash B2 dash as radius, get the arc. Clear? It will intersect your this line at some point and that point is your point B dash. Clear? This is the important thing. What we have to do is draw the line at an angle of 55 degree because front view angle is given. From B2 dash, get the arc. Both the intersection will giving you the point B dash. And here you can draw the line that is locus of B dash, because you have to draw the line. Now here you are having the locus line, because when you get the point B dash, you can be having the locus line, because you have to draw the position of your point B1 dash. Now you are having the true length. You are having the true length is 75 mm. You are having the true length and you are having the locus line. What in this case we are having? This is the true length and this is your point B1 dash on locus line. Now here we are having the true length. We are having the locus line. We are not having this angle. Okay, we are not having this angle. What we can do? Any idea what we can do is, we are having the locus line. We are having the distance, that is the length. So from A dash, A dash as center, and radius equal to, what we have to do is radius equal to 75. Get the arc. A dash as center, radius equal to 75 mm. Get the arc. It will intersect your this locus line at some point, and this will be your point B1 dash. You can join your point B1 dash. Clear? And this will be your angle theta. And after that, you can complete this, that you are having when B1 dash, you will be having your this point B1, and from B1 you can draw the arc. It will intersect this locus line at point B, and this will be your top view. So this will be your top view. This will be your front view. You can measure the angles. Here you can measure the angle beta. Clear? So always remember this figure. Or you can do is, in rough work, you can draw this figure, so you can be having the idea that now we can be having this point in which way, or we have to follow which step. Clear? So the same problem I will show on the slide also in animation. See, what we are doing is draw the line XY. Clear? Locate, first of all, locate the point A dash and A at a distance of 10 mm and 15 mm. Then the angle with VP is given 45 degree at an angle, and this length is given 75 mm. Locate the point B2. Clear? And the length is true length. Now the angle 55 degree, alpha is given, the front view angle is given. So 55 degree, we are drawing the front view line only, because length we are not knowing. The position of point B dash we are not knowing. So now what we can do is, from B2, this will be the locus line of point B. This will be the locus of point B. Clear? Now from B2, get the front view point, that is B2 dash, and that B2 dash from A dash as center, A dash B2 dash as radius, get the arc. It will intersect your this line at some point, and that will be your point B dash, which we have seen on this teletop. Clear? And so now you will be having the front view length, and you can be having the locus line. Now you will be having the locus line of locus of point B dash. Clear? And see, either you can draw in this way also, that B dash and B in a same line. Clear? But you have to follow the steps which I have shown on the teletop, that always draw your this true length A dash and B1 dash, and from B1 dash get the top view point and get the arc. You will be having the top view. So in this way you can solve the problem. Okay students, so what we have discussed in this session, that try to make the practice of this, because From the next session, we will be solving the some different problems or difficult problems on the same cases that the line is inclined to both the planes. So up to that, make the practice of this, the cases that when the line is inclined to both the planes. Okay, students, thank you.